Namaste, Assalamualaikum, a very happy Diwali to you all. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm once again happy to be here with you all this afternoon, and I'd like to thank you all for putting in your efforts and your contributions to mark the auspicious celebrations of Diwali for the Ministry of Education here in Suva. I'm sure there's a lot of effort that has gone in, and still I saw somebody just doing some fresh laddus, and I didn't know that we had so many experts here. But anyways, ladies, carry on with that. And looking at the costumes and the way you have prepared, I'd like to thank you for that, for showing the energy and the enthusiasm to celebrate this festival in a more multicultural manner. Your setup again is indeed mesmerizing, and definitely we have a lot of creative artists amongst us, and of course you all look wonderful here this afternoon. Assistant Minister was getting all excited, you know, and I think he had some ideas in his mind. I have to put a stop to it. See his smile. So I think I'll have to deal with him later on. But please be happy. Don't sit there as if you're walked down with misery and sorrow. Diwali is the time where we celebrate. Of course, we celebrate who we are. We celebrate the uniqueness of again, who you are, our identities. Just last night we were at the Gurmit Center in Rotoka, and exciting pre-Diwali celebrations. The theme for this Diwali celebration this year was honoring our senior citizens, and I think it's very apt, and that is something that we should all think of when we are going to partake in the festivities on Sunday. And of course there are students from our special schools in Rotoka who not only performed but added to the glory of the family bonding that we talked about. The day before that we were with our Bas special school children, and I think this year we can sort of reflect on the way we can assist those who are probably less privileged than us, who are less fortunate than us, who are sick and who may need our assistance and support. So please keep in your thoughts these people as you celebrate Diwali with your families. I think, ladies and gentlemen, our celebration here this afternoon gives us another reason to meet. And I must say, I know you by face. I still haven't got to know you by names, so please forgive me for that. There's so many of you. And each time I leave this basement, I come to know more people that work for the ministry. And I'd like to thank you for that. I know we are all busy, and it's Friday. You have to go back home and prepare for your family celebrations. You have to clear your tables. But sit back and relax the program. You know, this comes only once a year. And of course, like I said, when we get together, we sort of build on to the family or the family bond that we always talk about. And let's share the feelings of goodness, let's share the feelings of unity, let's share the feelings of happiness for the work that we do, for the service that we provide to the nation, for the ministry that we work for. I know it's not easy, I always say that. It's not easy working in this ministry. It's not easy for me, and I know it's not easy for you. But I think let's celebrate the fact that we can give the best to the nation in our capacities here at the Ministry of Education. Coming back to Diwali, I think for most of us non-Hindus, Diwali is all about sharing and probably visiting our friends and dressing up. And the fact that Diwali is more commercialized than before, we tend to sway away from the main reasons why we celebrate Diwali. But let's not forget that. Diwali is all about triumphing, defeating evil, being more positive, and of course the light that we've just lit. I'm sure this will illuminate your lives for the years to come and make you a better person. Ladies and gentlemen, in Fiji, I think Diwali is even more special. We are unique in our diversity, and each and every one of us will be fully committed, regardless of race or religion, when it comes to celebrating any festivals, be it Christmas, be it Eid, and now this Diwali. And that's what makes us unique. And of course, the public holiday gives us another opportunity to reflect on our lives. And of course, I am proud, and I'm sure you are equally proud of our diverse multiculturalism, the interactions we have, the heritage we have. These religious and cultural celebrations strengthen and allow us to embrace our rich diversity. I'm sure it helps us to root out any feelings of racism and inculcates values of acceptance. We need to accept each other and live peacefully in Fiji. At the same time, ladies and gentlemen, let us not forget where we get this heritage from. This year we celebrated 140 years for the arrival of our indentured laborers. And I think this is the very foundation of the religious festivals that we celebrate. They brought it to us. If you go back 140 years And if you go back to the time when the indentured laborers were first brought in the country, they brought with them their religion, they brought with them this culture. So if the onus is on us to carry it forward. And let us not forget the sacrifices our indentured laborers made, our forefathers made, and to bring us to where we are. So ladies and gentlemen, we need to recognize and acknowledge the role of the Gilmitias and our forefathers who helped us to where we are. And like I said, it's our duty now to preserve our cultural heritage. While we celebrate Diwali again, ladies, I'm sure you all go back home and decorate your homes with beautiful rangolis. That art, we should never let go of that. We still need to preserve. I don't know how many of us know how to do rangoli, but if you don't, maybe use these festivities to learn that. Coming back to sweets preparation, and like I said, Diwali is more commercialized now than ever. I mean, the last minute sales are still going on. Be wise in your spending. Okay? Be wise in your spending. Think about tomorrow. Be wise in your eating as well. I know we talk about NCDs, but again, we can say it's a one-off thing, so go easy on the sweets and the salt. Think of the elders and seniors in your homes who might not be that sensitive to the sweets, etc. Be kind to them as well. While you play with your firecrackers, think about the neighbor who might not be that privileged as you are. Think about those pets that people give, dogs and other animals that are very sensitive to firecrackers. Be mindful of that. And so I really think that we really need to reflect on who we were and who we are going to be after celebrating Diwali. The MC at the Gilmit Center last night made a very beautiful comment. One of the teachers from Lohu Sangam School, she said, whatever happened, 7:30 we started the program. She said, whatever happened before 7:30, let's forget that and let's embrace 7:31 as a new person. Yeah. Every moment can change our lives. So learn from these festivities, learn from this bonding, learn to share and care about each other, and let's make ourselves, I'm saying ourselves, we all have our flaws, but let's reflect on how this festival can help us become a better person for tomorrow. And on a serious note, ladies and gentlemen, I think these celebrations also help to bring about self-realization, right? And do that. And of course, we need to share with others what we have, and I'm sure you're going to do that. And let this Diwali be a time which gives us an opportunity to share our resources, our love with those underprivileged, the marginalized, and the needy in our society. Like I said, keep a track on your eating habits, and supervise your children when you play with firecrackers. I think Sunday is going to be a hive of firecrackers. We want this Diwali to be accident-free, on the road, at home. It becomes our responsibility to protect our children. And let us not dampen the spirit of 2019 Diwali through any mishaps and accidents that we can prevent. But ladies and gentlemen, make the simple diya that we have in front of you, the simple diya that you're going to light within your homes, within your facilities, may the modesty of this simple diya remind us that no matter how limited our resources are, no matter how many struggles we encounter, we need to keep burning. We need to keep burning like this little diya and make our country a much brighter and a happier place. And I believe if we all think positively, if we have goodness in our hearts, nothing should stop us from achieving what we do. So I know you are all looking for the festivities of the day. Of course, all the models I've been all trained by experts, and I'm really excited in seeing some exciting catwalks at the Ministry of Education. Who says we are second to none, right? So, and I'm sure you put in a lot of effort. So for those efforts, thank you all. Thank you very much. Thank you for making this Diwali a very special one. So on behalf of myself, my two daughters, Assistant Minister and his family, the Permanent Secretary who's out in Nandi, our directors, I'd like to wish you all, each and all, a very, very happy and a very, very joyous and a very prosperous Diwali. To the gentlemen who are out there, I'm sure you know Diwali is about praying to Goddess Lakshmi to bring you a lot of wealth. I'm sure you have your Lakshmis in your own lives and your Lakshmis in your own homes. Please look after them. Okay, look after them, and I'm sure wealth and success and prosperity will forever fill your home. So God bless you all and happy Diwali. Thank you.
everybody